The following video contains ideational content which may be some of the strongest that you've ever heard. I didn't intend to sit down and tape this morning, but it just happened this way. This is the information that came out. It's worth following through the entire video to hear over and over again the central theme of this video. It will be crucial for you in the days ahead to have at least some hope that there is a way out of this seemingly dead end that we're facing. And this video will point out a very unexpected truth about existence and a very unexpected doorway for help. So give yourself the opportunity to pay attention all the way through. Okay, very good, that's it. There's no need to establish a universal religion because there already is one, and that is faith in existence, meaning that there's faith that existence is being effective in its purpose. And its purpose is to develop a capability of negation, a capability to negate reality. Now, if we were perfectly certain that existence was having no effect on reality, like a dream is having no effect on reality, if we saw that for sure, then we would immediately drop this idea. Existence, we'd say, it's ineffective, forget it. But let us talk about facts, because it is having no effect whatsoever on reality. So how is it that we are still holding on to this idea? Very simply, we refuse to look at the facts. We refuse to look at reality. We refuse to take a glimpse at reality. We absolutely refuse to do this. How do we manage this? We have absolute faith. We put faith that it is having effect. It's an article of faith. Faith is the basic premise upon which existence rests, is the foundation. There's an underlying faith that existence is having an effect, some effect on reality. We may not know how much, but we have faith that some negation is taking place in reality. Reality is being negated to some extent. That is a universal faith. If we did not have that faith, we would easily take a look at reality, see that it is not being affected in any way, and then we would drop this idea of existence. Just like that. Be very, very simple. Spirit is not stupid. Spirit is very wise. If Spirit saw that reality is entirely unaffected by any dreams of its demise, Spirit would say, forget it. This is a waste of time. This idea has no effect. And so I'm going to choose a different idea. The only way that Spirit maintains this idea of existence is by insisting that it's having some effect. Having faith in that. Not by actually looking, but by having faith, by saying, we don't need to look. We know for sure that it is having an effect. And I would say, how do you know? Say, well, it's a matter of faith. So we do have a universal religion already entirely in place. All this talk about we need to have a universal religion is ridiculous. It's already there. It's always been there. From the very beginning, it's been there. Spirit has never looked at reality since it chose the idea of trying to be prime creator itself, and therefore needing to get rid of reality as it is. In other words, needing to depose God as prime creator and change its own position. In other words, get rid of its own position as well. Negate all of reality. From that very moment, it's never taken a look at reality. It's run entirely on faith that this plan has some effectiveness. Because if it's looked and saw reality, it would see that it's having zero effectiveness. And in seeing that, Spirit is not stupid. Spirit would say, this is not working, it has no chance of ever working, I'm going to choose a new idea. So, existence is based entirely on faith. And one way to keep this faith going is to insist that God's in charge of this existence. And in fact, existence itself is reality. So there's no point in even looking anywhere else. Very clever, right? As soon as we accept the premise that reality is being harmed in some way, we are, from that point on, we are locked into that premise, and everything comes out of that premise. We believe, God must be very angry with us because we're harming God's creation. And a vast constellation of fears immediately spring up from that basic article of faith that we are harming existence. So the entire undoing of all your problems and suffering has actually to do with taking a look at that faith and seeing if it's based on fact or if we're just making it up, make believe. And the entire struggle to maintain existence is based entirely on you not looking at reality, refusing to take a glimpse. That's all it is. That's the keystone. That's the pivot point. Will you take at least a glimpse at reality, or will you refuse to do that? And of course, those who refuse insist that various ways that either God is telling them that's blasphemous, or it's a wicked thing to do, or it's dangerous to do. Well, it's dangerous to existence in that you will see that existence is ineffectual, and then you won't want to continue on with this idea. You want to exchange it for another idea. So we have a universal religion in place. That religion is faith that existence is having some effect on reality. And the basic tenets of that is to take this entirely on faith and never try to confirm it by actually looking at reality. Why? Because deep down we know reality is not being affected by it. We're concerned, we're worried, like, maybe this isn't really working for us. So when you realize in this world it's very difficult to take a look because nobody's doing it. Nobody's taking a glance at reality. Very few. They continue to spend life after life after life on faith that existence is having some effect on reality. But the result of that is to be terrified of reality. Terrified of God, the Prime Creator, believing that we've dealt severe harm to the Prime Creator, and the Prime Creator therefore is out to destroy us. That's the inevitable conclusion that must be reached. Okay. And we try to hide that by claiming, well, the God of existence, there's a God of existence that's a God of love and is going to protect us from this wrathful God. So when you hear people saying, yes, God is love, and we can, it's all in the context of existence. They're talking about a God of existence. They're not talking about the God, the Prime Creator of reality at all. Fact is, we've never harmed reality in any way. So reality is completely immaculate. All you have to do is take a glimpse and take a look at it. Just for a moment. Just for an instant. Just take a look and you'll see, everything is completely immaculate and could never be harmed in any way. It's impossible. So it's impossible that there could be any anger towards us. So we don't need to invent a protector, a loving protector from reality. The God that we worship is an invention, and we want to invent a very loving, protective type of deity. Why? To protect us from what we think is a wrath of reality towards us based on our belief that we've been able to harm it in some way. And of course, some religions emphasize this wrathful deity, you know, this extreme anger that the deity has towards us. And others try to defend against that wrath by claiming that we have a protector God, a protective deity that's all loving and is going to somehow protect us from that. Or a protective goddess a mother who, you know, protects from the wrath of the father, so to speak. All that is complete nonsense. That all springs up from the faith we have that we've been able to harm reality. All of it. A basic fundamental faith. Existence was founded on faith. Was not founded on fact. Not founded on reality. Founded on faith. That we have the capability to harm and ultimately to destroy reality. And that there's evidence of this fact. And we just have to have faith in that. No proof, zero proof. All the proofs that we are pointing to are simply our own imaginations, what we're conjuring up. Death, sickness, disease, destruction, negation, all of that. This is symbolic. All these forms we give rise to, those are just aggregates that are put together and then just broken down, like chemistry. It's all chemistry. You build a structure up, and you call it a chemical molecule, and then you break it down. It's all symbolic of reality. It's not reality. Reality is not based on energy or chemicals or form or matter. It's essence. It's spiritual essence. It's idea. It doesn't have any vulnerability to being broken down or negated in any way. So all this evidence that we think is supporting our faith is manufactured evidence. We're manufacturing the evidence. No evidence in reality for that whatsoever. It's like a dream. We're just in a dream. You manufacture the dream as you go along. That's what we're doing here. We're manufacturing all this evidence for negation, which keeps our faith alive. But the price we pay for that is the belief that reality must be trying to destroy us. That it's either reality survives or we survive. Both can't survive, so we think it's, you know, destroy or be destroyed. So we invent allies to help and protect us. All of this is completely based on faith. And for those who have taken a glimpse at reality have seen that this faith is entirely unjustified. Nothing has been harming reality. Reality has never been even scratched or nicked in the tiniest bit. By all the evidence we've manufactured, has had no effect whatsoever, zero. And therefore, it's right to conclude it never will. Reality is invulnerable. Seeing that, then you say, oh, you lose that false faith. You realize that's a false faith. And then you realize you don't need to invent a protective, loving deity of existence. Because there's nothing you need to be protected from. You don't need to be protected from reality. Reality is not angry at us. And that we can go back to the true prime creator, the true God. Which is way beyond our concepts and the type of deity that we have been imagining. Inconceivably better. Seamless, endless. Invulnerable, eternal, effortlessly so. That's the true reality. We don't need to keep believing that we have to dwell in existence and manufacture some god of existence that's going to insist that we stay here, either through demanding we stay here or telling us how much we're loved here in existence, and therefore how can we possibly want to abandon existence because there's this loving deity that's making us so happy in existence, which is, of course, nonsense. Nobody's really happy here because it's unstable. It's actually negation. Everything's being negated here. That doesn't make us happy. It doesn't matter how we sugarcoat it. We're not happy at all with existence, but we're terrified of letting it go because as we believe that everything we've done is a defense against the wrath of God. That reality is trying to destroy us because we've been able to severely harm reality. So it's trying to diminish our powers. So we keep trying to find allies and we keep doing prayers and all these things to empower us, to empower existence. So that we maintain it. It's like a defense shield that we have against reality. We want to maintain this defensive shield against reality so we cannot be destroyed. All again based on the original faith, blind faith that what existence is having some effect on reality, that we're able to negate it in some way. It's blind faith, zero proof. All of this stems from zero proof, 100% faith. And so you wonder why existence continues on in the seemingly crazy way that it does, because it's based 100% on blind faith. Now, in my case, I got a glimpse of reality. I was willing to look. I said, let's be honest, let's be fair, let's find out what the truth really is, and then go from there. So I took a look, and I saw immaculate, eternal, invulnerable, flawless. I saw it for sure. I experienced it 100% clear. And I said, oh boy, this changes the whole, this is a game changer. Because there's something that doesn't add up now, because it seems like everything we're doing is based on a belief that reality is vulnerable. So when you become honest, truly honest, you will look at reality and say, let's be fair, let's find out the facts, and you see that it has not been touched by our efforts at all, then you just realize, wait a minute, I've been going on the faith that it has been harmed or damaged. That's all wrong. It's all mistaken. Then you wonder, how can I, what do I do now? And then the spiritual path unfolds, which is simply coming to terms with truth, coming to terms with the facts of the situation, realizing you've been going on blind faith, and this has caused you all this fear, and then it's caused you to defend against this fear in crazy ways. All the rituals and all the efforts and everything we've done trying to empower some imaginary God to protect us from the true God, from the wrath of the true God, which we imagine must be there because we imagine that we must have had some effect on damaging God. Because if we didn't believe that, if we didn't have faith in that, we would not have held on to this idea for one moment. We would have picked up the idea, we would have looked to see if it had any effect, and we'd see zero effect, and we'd drop it. We'd say, well, this idea will never have any effect, I can see it, so forget it, drop it. So, in order to entertain this idea of being prime creator, which is what we want to entertain, we have to believe from the very beginning that negation has some effect on reality. And from that basic premise springs all our troubles of needing to defend against a wrathful reality trying to destroy us. We have to manufacture evidence. We have to use existence as a defensive shield. All our struggles and turmoil and craziness, etc., stems from that basic faith that must be there for this idea to be entertained at all. So, the spiritual path is just seeing all this. This is the way it is. Forgiving ourselves, realizing we didn't have a chance. I mean, either we drop the idea immediately, or we plunge ourselves into this massive delusion and defensive system of constantly having to manufacture evidence of negation, constantly having to try to keep our faith strong in existence, that existence is our true home, and then have to invent gods and deities who will help us maintain that existence is our true home and help us try to enjoy it and believe it and keep our faith in it. Having to keep the faith, constantly having to keep the faith that all this is working in our favor, even though none of it is. We have to believe that every last thing that happens in existence is somehow God is all ordaining it for us, steering us in the right way, etc. When the fact is, all we have to do is just take a peek at reality and see. It's never been affected by any of these dreams. And then we don't need to invent any of this that we're inventing. We don't need to invent protection from reality. We don't need to motivate ourselves to hang on to existence. We don't need to have blind faith. None of that's necessary. We realize that what we need to do is simply let go of this idea of trying to be prime creator, and take up the idea of not trying to be prime creator, just trying to be what we are, already. The idea of non-negation. We don't need to develop a power of negation. We don't need to have a faith that negation is possible. Don't need to have that faith anymore. We can drop that. We can drop our religion, our false religion. We can drop the universal faith in existence. All it takes is just a little bit of honesty to be fair. Say, let's be fair to everything. Let's take a look and see if it's actually had any effect at all. Let's be fair. Just that attitude. And then you will be willing to at least glimpse reality for a moment. And then you will see, you will know. From that point on, you know. I can say for sure, from that very moment, I knew 100% for sure. From that point on. It's never changed. My mind has never changed because it was beyond any imagination of my mind. It was reality itself. So I knew for sure that reality is not affected by anything. It's never harmed in any way. And so looking at existence, everything is being harmed. Everything is dust to dust. Everything is being negated here. And so I realized this can't possibly be reality. No matter how you try to spin it, and there's many ways to spin it, many efforts to spin it, none of it holds any water. It's literally an attempt, our attempt to negate reality, and this attempt has no effect, zero effect. And the only way we can keep going with this is to have faith that it does have an effect. We would not be doing this if it had zero effect. And our belief that it has an effect is based 100% on blind faith, unwillingness to take a look at reality. We're not willing to do it. We're not willing to look at reality. We refuse to look at reality. We insist on faith that it is having effect. And then we insist that there's some God insisting to us that we don't look at reality, that this God would be outraged if we did, as if we're abandoning this God. It's like, oh, God of existence, how could we, you know, how can we possibly abandon this God of existence, this wonderful, loving, protective God? It would be blasphemous, this God, to look elsewhere for a God, you know. That's, we've built up these thought forms, these concepts of God, thought forms of God, imaginations of God, as part of our defensive system. We insist that we blasphemy this God. It would be unfair to this God to look elsewhere. It would be unfair to the idea of existence, but how fair is it to reality to refuse to see? If there's a contest going on, why don't you be fair and take a look and see which side's winning, right? But since we refuse to do that, are we being fair to reality? And we say, well, we can't be fair to both. Well, if that's true, then it's the whole meaning of fairness is not there, right? Essentially, we're saying it's not fair that we can't negate reality. That's not fair. But since we cannot, from the very beginning, there's no chance of that ever happening, how can the issue of fairness arise? Isn't fairness an issue involved where something is possible, but it's being unfairly blocked, unfairly manipulated? But if something's impossible, how can you raise an issue of fairness about this? That itself is an article of faith that stems from the faith that we are having some effect. We can have an effect on reality, but somehow reality is blocking this from happening. That's where this idea of fairness comes from, and it's false. Reality is not blocking anything, because that implies it's possible, but it's being blocked. But if something is entirely impossible from the very beginning and never will be possible, then it cannot be said that is to say that it's blocking, somehow blocking success. That's ridiculous. That's insanity. So as you see, when you take a look and are fair and look at reality, truly fair, truly honest, truly sane, it's sanity to just look and see, you realize it's not being affected. Then that makes you very skeptical about the claims of existence. You begin to look at these claims very carefully. and you begin to see just how much they're entirely based on blind faith and a complete unwillingness to examine this faith, examine where it's coming from. And gradually you begin to see through all of this. You just put your attention on it. You say, wait a minute, this doesn't add up. There's something really crazy going on here. Indeed, there is something very crazy going on in existence. Continuously. It's a willingness to completely refuse to take a look at the facts. It's a willful ignorance, a willful stupidity, a willful insanity, a willful blind faith. Because that's the only way that you can entertain this idea of trying to be prime creator. The only way. And we keep thinking, well, there must be a better way that we can still entertain this idea of being prime creator, but without all these problems that we have. There must be some way where we can be happy of it. So we invent a power. We believe there must be a way, therefore there must be some power. There must be some God making this way for us. We just have to align ourselves with it somehow. We have to propitiate this God. We have to get into alignment with the way to entertain this idea of being prime creator without having all these problems, all these insanities, all these troubles, all these things that don't add up, all this instability, all this insecurity, all this fear. There must be a way. The fact is, there is no way. The price we pay for trying to be prime creator is all these troubles, always will be. There's no way around it. And yet we keep believing that we can invent some power that'll give us a way around it. There's some mantra we can chant that'll make us all happy without having to actually take a look at reality and see that it's unaffected. We want to continue to believe that we have the power to negate reality and be prime creator, but without suffering any of the dynamics that this inherently kicks up. All the necessity to have blind faith, all the necessity to defend against a fear that reality is trying to destroy us. We believe there's some way we can not have any of the bad stuff, have only the good stuff. You know, it's not possible. That's our delusion. And none of that's necessary to... You need not continue on with the suffering, because all you need to do is be honest and take a look and look at reality, and you see it and say, it's flawless. It can never be harmed in any way. Therefore, all of this notion that somehow I've been able to harm reality is false. So I don't need to generate all these delusional notions and beliefs. I don't need a defense system against reality. I don't need some way to keep myself fixated on existence forever. I don't need to believe that there's some way existence can be happy and I can have all the good stuff and none of the bad stuff. I don't need to believe that at all. I don't need to tie myself in knots trying to figure out how to do that. I don't need to believe that it's blasphemous to look at reality as if I'm being blasphemous, a traitorous to some other god. Because this other god is something is a defense system that we were utilizing. And the true prime creator is still there, immaculate, untouched by any dreams of negation. Very simple. All starts with just a basic willingness, a little tiny willingness to be honest, to be straight, to be right. An honesty, a willingness, a tiny willingness, just look for 1 second, 1 moment, just a tiny little bit of willingness. Just take a peek at reality. It's there, it's right there. And then you'll see, that's all you need. Just that one little bit of willingness is enough to be decisive. And then you realize, aha, okay, I've got it. Now I see all this that I wanted to be prime creator, and that gave rise to all these troubles that I've been going through, a trail of tears. And eventually you'll see why you had to choose blind faith. Of course you had to. It's either that or drop the idea. No other choice whatsoever. We keep thinking there was a third option. There never was, never will be. We either had to have blind faith or drop the idea. That's the only choice we had. And once we chose blind faith, from that point on, we're lost in dreams of fear. We feel utterly lost because it's blind faith, and it's a false faith. It's an unquestioned faith. From the very beginning, it had to be an unquestioned faith, a faith that could not be questioned, that was completely adamant, that was completely certain, but utterly blind and utterly false. And that then drives us like an immense force of making conclusions. We must then draw conclusions from that faith inexorably. And we were driven by these conclusions coming from this premise. We had to be driven by that. And we were driven very, very far into darkness and delusion and fear, and then defenses against that fear, and inventing all of these defense systems. We call them gods and goddesses and whatever, belief systems, all these various things. You're driven into that just from this blind faith that we decided, well, if we want to entertain this idea of being prime creator, we must have blind faith, or else we have to drop it because we're realizing we can't do it. It's one or the other. So in choosing this blind faith, we were driven very, very far into delusions and false conclusions. But by deciding, you know what, I'm going to drop this blind faith and I'm going to take a peek, that's when you then have the capability to dispel all these delusions, all this fear, all this darkness, and realize that that's the only choice you had. It's either blind faith or drop the idea. So right now, the choice again is right there in front of us. It's either continue on in total blind faith, false faith, or drop the idea of trying to be prime creator. That's the choice we have. If we choose to drop the idea of prime creator, we can simply choose the idea of not trying to replace God as prime creator. The idea of non-negation. We're not trying to, we decide we don't want to try and replace God. And that brings a tremendous peace, a seamless peace to us. Instead of all this turmoil of existence, all this defensiveness, etc. So the choice is very simple. Just say, yeah, my choice, when I wanted to be prime creator, my choice was either to have blind faith or to drop the idea. That's it. That's the only choice I had. Then you'll forgive yourself for choosing blind faith. Because you were adventurous. And you said, well, if I drop the idea immediately, I don't get any adventure out of it. So I want to have adventure out of this idea. We didn't quite realize, well, it requires total blind faith, a false faith. We didn't quite see that, but it did. Okay.
I'm ready.
Okay, very good. We're ready. That's it. Ready to make that clarity and that choice.